Going on, everyone. Welcome to the RabidMining YouTube channel, and you guys are not going to want to miss this. Well, maybe you will. You don't care. Maybe you're mining KASPA. Maybe you're not. Who knows? Regardless, earlier we did look at lolMiner version 1.63 in HiveOS and showed you how to set this up with using the core voltages as using an actual voltage set and then locking your core within the mining software. And a lot of you guys are curious, how do you do this in Windows? So that's what we're going to look at today, showing you how to do this in Windows. And I got this here just to kind of compare power consumption. So let's go have a look. So here we are on the test bench in Windows, and we can see lolMiner 1.63. Let's just kind of zoom in a little bit. There we go. And I was in the middle of actually downloading the latest NVIDIA driver because I only have like 512 something in right now. But I did my testing while I waited for this and it was working just fine. So I was like, okay, whatever. I'm not even going to install it. Doesn't matter. I don't have an LHR GPU. My RTX 30 EVGA is non-LHR before LHR was a thing. So I have no issues of unlocking it or anything. So I'm just going to right click here. We're going to look into our lolMiner bat file. Once it's done thinking, this is an old crappy processor within this test bench, but that's okay. We don't need nothing fancy when it does come to mining. Again, my test bench only uses about 20 to 22 watts from the complete system. So everything, we'll just subtract our numbers and kind of see what we got. So here is how you set up this bat file. So you got to start with your pool. Some of you may see here, I have US1 KASPA-pool, and you're like, well, how come you're not on Wooly Pooly? Everyone's on Wooly Pooly. Isn't that the top pool? Yes, Wooly Pooly is currently the top pool on KASPA, but there has been more and more people coming forward saying they're not seeing the same hash rate at the pool as they are seen within the miner. Now, that's because of one of two reasons. One, the miner may be false reporting, or the pool just isn't that good, bottom line. So I'm going to do this test on KASPA pool. I'm not testing any hash rates, but I just wanted to connect to a different pool because we've always used Wooly Pooly for KASPA. So we're going to try something else. In the future, I do plan on doing that test. I'm going to take some exact same GPUs, 0.1 at Wooly Pooly, 0.1 at KASPA pool, run it for, 24 to 48 hours and see what the reported hash rate at the pool actually is, if one is accepting more shares than the other, and we'll know if it's a pool issue or a miner issue. And if it's a miner issue, then obviously lolMiner is fake reporting hash rates. But I cannot confirm anything yet. I believe MindSum has been working on this as well. So maybe he has some data for us available by now, but I'm not sure. But I will be trying these tests out in the future here because I'm kind of curious on what may be going on. But the reports are coming in by multiple people. All right, so back to our flight sheet. I'm actually going to make this a little bigger so you can see a little more of what's going on here. So obviously, we start with our algo here. We got KASPA. Here's our pool. We put in our pool user. This is your wallet address right here. And then you put a period and then your worker name. Now, when we go over all the way to the right, this will not be here. It'll have your explanation marks and say extra perimeter configs, whatever it did say. I can't remember, but it'll say extra something all in capital letters. This is where you actually do your within the mining software overclock. So here we can see dash dash cclk space 1470. This is to lock your core at 1470. And then we got the dash dash mclk 810. This is to lock your memory at 810. I will have both of these in the description below if you want to just copy and paste it in. Just for a cross reference here with HiveOS, it is the exact same thing that we have here in our extra config section here. So exact same settings we're going to use here. And if I actually go into my workers, I'm going to scroll down, bring up the test bench here. You can see we have a core of 400. Now setting your core up means you're dropping your voltage down for less power consumption, equaling more efficiency. So coming back into our test bench here, we have these lock settings in. So this is locking it within the software. And now we got to adjust our core and everything. And that's going to be done within Afterburner itself. So if I actually bring up Afterburner, if I can find it, here it is. It's probably going to double click itself again. What is going on? There we go. All better. So here you can see I have plus 400 on the core, within MSI Afterburner. This is acting the same way as HiveOS, setting 400 core in HiveOS. Now remember, it is memory that you really gotta watch in terms of setting it, where on 3000 series, it is doubled. So 4000 memory within HiveOS is 2000 memory in Windows 10. But we're not doing anything memory here. We have that locked. We're not adjusting that at all. All right, so now that we have all our settings locked in, I'm simply gonna double click on the KASPA miner. And I did forget to mention, you're going to want to run LOL miner as an admin. So once you hit yes here, we're gonna let this thing do its thing. I'm just gonna show you that it's locking its core and everything. It's memory clock and it's core clock. There you can see it applied the lock clock or lock core here of 1470, as well as the memory at 810. And again, we're using that plus 400 for the voltage control. I do have my capture card plugged into the GPU, so we're probably not going to get the exact same hash rate. It will be slightly lower because we are using the screen in this case. But hopefully we can get pretty close here and we'll get an idea of our power consumption. So while that's doing that, I'm just going to bring up how to run this as admin if you're running a bat file on a shortcut or something. So if I go to downloads here, we go back to LOL miner, come into here. We just want to find the LOL miner program here, right click on it, hit properties, go to compatibility, just like you do with your CPU miners, XM rig or something, hit the check mark on run this program as an administrator. You must run it as an admin in order for these lock core clocks and everything to actually apply. So now we're actually in here. Let's have a look at some power consumptions. And as we can see, it's around 135 to 137, which is pretty close to exactly what we did have in HiveOS previously. So we're using the same amount of power. We're hanging in at about, okay, I just had everything open so we can see our hash rate dropped. This is some of the issues by having it plugged in directly to my capture card. We have to let everything sit and let that hash rate come up. But up top, you can see we're around 703 there. So we are breaking 703 mega hash there again. But our power consumption is pretty much exactly the same. So we are doing the same. The only thing that's really different, actually, that's pretty close to software power is reporting a little bit lower, but not too much. But there you go. That's how you set up LOL miner 1.63. within Windows 10 and tweaking that efficiency for KASPA mining. Now, again, remember, you can continue on, you can add more core, take away some core, whatever, but the higher the number on the core is the less voltage for more efficiency. Go until it crashes regardless. So thank you for checking out this video. Hopefully it does help you out. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.